Hey everyone, I recently got the light messenger from Lab401. Good news, it uses open source software for the Flipper Zero app. Not only is it open source, but the folks over at Lab401 have been super responsive to integrating changes from Rocket God and myself. The light messenger is a persistence of vision accessory for the Flipper Zero. In this video, we'll do an overview of the light messenger, and in a future video, I'll show you how to change the code. You can get a discount and support this YouTube channel by using promo code Derek at checkout. Let's get started. They did a great job on the artwork for the light messenger. Over in the bottom right corner, you can see the accelerometer, which detects motion. On the back of the light messenger, you'll see all kinds of information about data. For example, you could encrypt data with a symmetric key using XOR. I really like the Morse code section. You move to the left for dots and the right for dashes. For example, the letter K, we start by going right, so dash, and then we go left, so dot, and K is the second letter, so dash. Later in this video, we'll also take a look at these test points. On the edge of the board are 16 RGB LEDs. These are SK6805 LEDs, but I think they work similar to the WS2812B that I showed in previous videos. To install the app, make sure QFlipper is not running and that your Flipper Zero is plugged in. In a Chrome or Edge browser, go to lab.flipper.net/apps, search for Lab401, click on Light Messenger, and then click on the Install button. And this will install the application under Apps GPIO on your Flipper Zero. If you scroll down to the bottom of the page and click on Repository, you'll see the source code for the project, which I'll look at in another video. And then there's also great documentation. This documentation covers how we can use the application, as well as if you want to extend the application, it talks about development, circuit diagrams with details on both the accelerometer and the LEDs, and also information about data formats. All right, let's go into Apps, GPIO, and then Light Messenger. And you can see I don't have the hardware connected, and you'll get a hardware module not found error. So go ahead and connect up your module. And again, you can get that module at lab401.com and promo code Derek. This time you see the splash screen, and then it has a flashlight where it uses all 16 lights on bright white, super bright flashlight. And then the about screen has a couple of pages of both the Lab401 and the primary engineer that worked on the project. Again, here's that splash screen. And then in configuration, if you say wheel up, it means that you're holding your flipper with the wheel facing up. And if you say wheel down, you're holding your flipper in this orientation. For sensitivity, you can choose high or low. It's basically how much motion the accelerometer needs to detect before it considers it a swipe. You can see there's tons of different colors here. And there's even some animated colors. And we can talk in a future video on how to add your own colors if that's something that would be of interest to people. This will swipe red one direction and blue in the other. I found a physical mirror was easiest for debugging, so I have mirror image enabled when I'm using that mirror. And the letter width is how long those pixels are on. So narrow will make the image pretty tight and wide will make it pretty wide. By default, it shows the full word that you've typed, but if you say slow or fast, fast is every half second, and slow is every second. It'll show one word of your message. And for this demo, I'll actually use rainbow as the color. We'll go ahead and click back, and then I'll go into the text option and we'll change our message. The default message is Lab401. So I'll go ahead and delete that. And then we'll use a message of 3. And then for a space, we'll hold the underscore. And then 2. And again, to get space, we hold the OK on the underscore. 1. and space. And then for capitals, we can hold the letters as well. So I'll do go here. And I'll save the message. Filming was terrible, so let me go ahead and enable mirroring. And I'm still struggling to get a good focal point, but this looks great in person. The last feature I wanted to show was the bitmap editor. And we'll go ahead and create a new bitmap. So these bitmaps are black and white, 16 pixels high, and then typically 32 pixels wide. You can use a standard photo editor with, as long as you save the format as 16 pixels high, it should work. And if the file's not loading, you can look in your debug logs for information as to what the failure was. In a future video, maybe we'll edit the code so that you're being able to load multiple BMPs in an animation. Also, if you click on a pixel that's already set, it clears the pixel. Once you're done drawing, press the back button to save it, and it'll save it in SD card apps data 401 Lite MSG, and it'll save it with a BMP extension. And here you can see our custom bitmap. So the final thing I wanted to do was take a look at these six test points. And so I'll label them 1 through 6 on the paper. I've got my ohm meter set up so that when the two wires connect and it's below 45 ohms, it'll make a beep. And we'll go for 3.3 pin, nope, ground. And we're getting it on ground. Let's try the other ground. And the other ground works as well. I've moved over to test point 2. Try 3.3. And it is 3.3. Next, we're on test point 3. 3.3. Ground 5. And it is the 5 volt pin. 3.3. Ground 5. That's pin A7 on the flipper. Okay, so that's C1. And finally, that's what I guessed was pin C0. Here's my little test harness. We'll go to apps, GPIO, and then I2C tools. I'll go ahead and put scan, and you'll see no devices found. Now I'll put them over the pins, and we'll do a scan again. My test harness doesn't have perfect contacts. And there we go. We can see one device at address 18 hex. So that means our accelerometer is working and responding. Next, I'll run the WS2812B LED tester that I wrote. And we'll set our LED count to 16 pins. And then we'll choose a colorful pattern, a medium LED speed, and a little bit of brightness. And make sure that that 5 volt pin is enabled, since that's what they're using for the lights. And we can see all of the LEDs have been soldered correctly. For a real test harness, you'd probably use pogo pins like the ones found on the back of your Flipper Zero. These have little springs, so they're able to make better contact with the circuit. Please like and subscribe and leave a comment below, or you can contact me on Discord.